In this video, we'll try to understand what is the difference between equal to comparison and comparing by using the dot equals method. Now, when we create any object, there are two parts to that object. One is the content of the object, and the other one is reference to that content. So, for example, you can see on your screen, I have a very simple object here called as O, and which has a content .NET interview questions. So .NET interview questions actually becomes the content, and the O becomes the reference to that content. Now the equal to sign compares if the object references are same, while the dot equals method compares if the contents are same. Now here's a simple example we have on the screen. I have created a simple object called as O, and I have pointed this O towards a content called as .NET interview questions. Then, in the next line, I'm creating one more object called as O1, and this O reference I'm passing to O1. So what will happen internally is, you know, basically both O and O1 will point towards the same reference, and they will also have the same content. So now if we do a equal to comparison, and if we use the dot equals method to do the comparison, both of them should give us output as true, because the content is same as well as the references are same. So if I go and do a control F5 over here, you can see that it is returning me true, you know, for equal to comparison, and it is also returning me true for the dot equals method comparison. Now let us go ahead and change this code a bit. Now let me go here to this object O1, and let me go and create a new fresh string object and pass it to O1. So I'll take the same content. So Control C, Control V. Right. Now this is really getting interesting. Now in this scenario, what will happen is we will have object O, which is pointing towards .NET interview questions content. We'll have one more object O1, which is pointing towards the same content, .NET interview questions, but it is a fresh and a new instance. So now in this scenario, the equal to comparison should return false. And when we use the dot equals method to do the comparison, it should return true. Why? Because, you know, the content is same, but the object references are different. So if I now do a control F5 here, just watch the output. The equal to comparison is showing false. Why? Because we have different object references. But the dot equals comparison, the method comparison, is showing true. Why? Because the content is same. .NET interview questions and .NET interview questions. So summarizing, when you want to do an object reference comparison, or if you want to check that two objects are pointing towards the same reference, use the equal to sign. But if you want to check if the contents are same, right, then use the dot equals method. Now this whole thing actually starts becoming interesting when we talk about string data type. If you see, if you go and create a string data type, right, even in string, you will find that there is a dot equals method, right, because string is an object, right, at the end of the day. And also you can do a comparison like this with string, right. So with string data type, you know, things are a bit different. For string data type, you either use the equal to sign for comparison, or you either use the dot equal sign for comparison. It will always and always and always and always do content comparison. So in other words, if I go here and if I say here string, and if I say here string, right? Now, even though this O1 is pointing towards a new reference, the output is true and true here. So you can see over here, the equal to sign actually returns true, and as well as the dot equals method comparison also returns true. So there are three important points, you know, which we can take away from this video. First, the equal to sign helps us to do object reference comparison. The dot equals method helps us to do content comparison. And if you are using a string data type, it always does a content comparison. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what is the difference between equal to comparison and the dot equals method comparison. Thank you so much.